Hey, Chewie, you hear they're finally making a movie about us? You said it, pal. Boy, I really hope they don't mess up our story. Now fire up the Falcon. What do you mean you ain't the keys?
Oh, hi. Sorry you had to see that. I'm Miles of my review, Things You Need to Know. And today is a special day because I'm going to be talking about Solo, a Star Wars story. That just came out this weekend on May 25th. And just so you know, I am trying not to provide any spoilers whatsoever because it just came out this weekend and I know people are a little iffy about seeing it since it's Memorial Day weekend, but I promise you I will try to keep as much spoilers to a minimum. Sound good? Great. So, let's get started. Now, to first introduce the story, I think it deserves to be said right. Solo's story is mostly the one that everybody has anticipated over the last couple of years, and since Star Wars is such a big phenomenon, it's been going on for almost 40 years, and they are still trying to expand the franchise in the universe as much as they possibly can, and really, I say this is where it drops the ball, because it's... For content-wise, it's decent, but in the Star Wars universe, it is really confusing and it just feels unnecessary to the character development that is Han Solo.
I'm a driver, and I'm a flyer. I waited a long time for a shot like this.
Amount of action and the digital effects have changed over the last 40 years since the original trilogy came out in theaters, and also I think it's probably the fact that we get to see a new side of Chewie. Chewie really brings it home because he is the best sidekick anyone can have in a sci-fi movie like this, because he is the general icon of what a best friend can be in his relationship with Han Solo, and just how they meet and how their bond and their co-piloting becomes more solid as we look through the eyes of this iconic character. And we also get to learn a couple more things about Chewie that we didn't know in the previous movies.
Since when do you know how to fly? 190 years old? You look great!
For an all-star cast, it's pretty good. We got Woody Harrelson as the mentor to young Han Solo. We have the Mother of Dragons herself, Emilia Clarke, playing the love interest before Princess Leia. And we have Donald Glover from Childish Gambino, who plays the charming and yet somewhat charismatic Lando Calrissian.
A story about you. I was wondering if it's true.
Everything you've heard about me is true.
The thing they do wrong in this movie would probably be the confusing storylines, because it is feeling like we are learning a little too much about Han Solo than we need to know. Like the fact that he got his name from the incident in the beginning, and we are trying to understand this character, and we learn that Han Solo is real name was never Solo. It was something else. But we learn how he got his name, which is a little bit misleading for some of the older fans who grew up watching the franchise. And plus, it is so weird watching some kid playing the most iconic role in the sci-fi universe, played by Harrison Ford, which is really weird because we are so used to Han Solo being this scoundrel in the Star Wars universe, because Harrison Ford plays it so well in the original trilogy and in the sequel trilogy with Star Wars The Force Awakens. Another issue with this movie is that they are recycling old parts from the older movies, and they are just throwing it all together in this one single origin story. I mean, they don't bring anything new to the character. Like, it's the same arc for the Han Solo as we are seeing in A New Hope and the other movies like Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi. It's basically the same thing. Han Solo is the bad boy of the group, and he's progressing into a good guy, which is really, really good in the original movies, but now they are using the same concept. There is nothing new about it. They're just taking everything about this character from the old movies, and they are mixing it up into this new backstory of from when he was younger. And it's understanding that they want to recreate this character, but I mean, you gotta add something new into this origin story of how he became who he was when he meets Luke, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and Princess Leia. And besides, it's really mostly about him learning how to steal and where he got the Millennium Falcon. I mean, you gotta add something new to this character to understand how he became who he was when we're first introduced to him on Tatooine in A New Hope. Also, get out of the picture, Khaleesi. You're not supposed to change Han Solo. That was Carrie Fisher's job.
I like the sound of that.
Stop that.
I'm beginning to rant, but I think it's mostly the fact that it's an origin story movie, and you never really expect much from any of those, because if you know what's going to happen in the next couple of movies before that, then there's really not a lot of room to be surprised when you actually see what's happening in this.
If you come with us, you're in this life for good.
You're listening to me rant on about Solo, A Star Wars Story, and don't let my ranting stop you from going to see this movie and forming your own views on how it should be. And if anything I said made sense, then feel free to comment and give me some of your input into my YouTube page. That could really help me understand where you guys might see how I might be wrong or how I might be right. I might be interested in hearing what your opinion of the movie was too. And all the Star Wars fans out there, I hope you see this movie, and if it feels like it was unnecessary or a waste of $20, then I would say you live and learn. Anyway, thanks for listening to my review, Things You Need to Know, and may the Force be with you.